A very good evening to all of you and welcome back to our channel The Teacher. This is Rajiv and today I'm going to show you that how you can create this rotational text effect in PowerPoint 2016. You can use different kind of speed and different rotational options as you can see in this presentation. So let's get started. First of all, I'm going to take a new presentation by clicking on the file menu, then click on new and then choose blank presentation. Collapse this thumbnail view and change the layout from the home tab to blank. So first of all, I will write the text using the word art feature from the insert tab. You can choose any of these word art style. I am going to use this black one. And here I am going to type the text that I will animate. And let's choose the font. And I will choose, let's see the list, and I will use E-Square. I think that is the name of that font. So where is that? Yes, E-Square. And we'll increase the size a bit and we'll adjust this text in the middle and the center of the slide from the format tab. Click the align drop down button and choose align center and then align middle. You can also turn on guides from the view menu to see the exact position of the text. So the next thing is to draw an oval here and choose the oval from the shape menu and then just click inside the presentation and that will create a default 1x1 size oval and then adjust this oval in the center and the middle of the slide just as we did for the text and choose no fill from the shape fill drop down button and change the outline color to black. So the next thing is to copy and paste this oval here approximately 7, 8 or 10 times. So after selecting the oval, click copy and then paste it 7 or 8 times. 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay, I'm going with 10. That's fine. Now open the selection pane from the home tab. Click the select drop down button and choose selection pane and hide the text here. And then select all of these ovals by clicking on the select drop down button again and choose select all. From the format tab, click align drop down button and choose align to slide first. And then again choose align center and then align middle to adjust all the ovals in the middle of the slide. Now show the text by clicking on the I button and you will start seeing the text again. So the next thing is adjusting the size of these oval according to the text. So after selecting the last oval here, as you can see here, I have selected the oval number 13. And then start increasing the oval size by holding the Ctrl, Shift and Alt keys and then use the left mouse button to increase the size and I will set it right here. Now the next oval and again increase the size and I will set it right here. Now the fourth oval, I will set it right here. In the middle of the E and before the H and then again always hold down Ctrl Alt and Shift keys while increasing or decreasing the size to change the size simultaneously from all the sides. I think that will be fine here. Again, okay, that will be fine right here. And that will be right here. And finally, in the end, and one more oval after all the text. Okay, I think we have more ovals here that we no longer require. So I will delete this one, the fifth one, by selecting it from the selection pane and then hit the delete key. Okay, so the next thing will be to select all these oval without the text. So I will hide the text and will choose select all command from the home tab and will make a copy of all of these ovals by clicking copy and paste command and then move them sideways and also make a group of them from the format tab. Click group drop down button and choose group and place it sideways. Okay, now you can hide it for the time. And the next thing will be selecting all of these ovals again, and then in the end I will select the text. So I will start from right here and then hold down the shift key to select rest of the ovals, or you can also use selection pen to select all of these ovals. And in the end I will select the text. And now from the format tab, click merge shapes drop down button and choose fragment. After using the fragment command, you need to delete all of these ovals one by one. And that will be the right time to choose the right fill color that you need for your text. So if you want a different color than white, then you can change it right now by selecting all of these shapes and choose shape fill drop down button and select the desired color you want. So make sure if you are going to choose, let's say the orange color, then you have to choose the same outline color as well. So you will no longer will see these black lines because of the fragment command. So I will go with black. Black fill and black outline. So the next thing will be deleting the unnecessary parts here, just like this scare in the E, and same here. That's fine. I think it's right here. Okay, that's fine. Now show all of those ovals that we have copied in the previous step, and from the format tab choose align center and align middle command, and then ungroup them. The most important thing here is to group all of these separate part of the text with the ovals. So as E is separate from all of the other shapes in the presentation, so I will select E first and then will apply the spin animation to it. Okay. Now the next thing we need to do is to select the oval first and then start selecting the parts of the text, just like this part of the A here and this part of the A and then this part of the T. And make a group of them from the format tab, click group, and you can rotate this text to see if everything is working fine. Yes, it is. Now the next thing will be to select the second oval and rest of the parts of the same letter. Okay, I think that's fine. Make a group and rotate it to check if everything is fine here. Yes. Now the third oval and the rest part of the A and T, and make a group of them. That's fine. So you have to take care of that which parts you have already selected and with which oval you have grouped them. So I have already used three ovals here for the T, E and A letters, and now I will choose the fourth oval and will select these part of the E and that part of the C and make a group of them. That's fine. I think I have included all the shapes and grouped them properly. You can check that by seeing the selection pen here. And if anything is outside from the group area, then you will see that right here. So if I start unchecking these, you will notice that which part has not been included in the group section. As you can see that, okay, I think these parts are not much important here. Okay, that's fine. So I hope you might got my point that what we need to do to create this rotational text animation, you have to group these items very carefully so no part of the text remain ungrouped. So the final thing will be to apply the animation, and that is very easy. Select all of these groups and go to the animations tab, click add animation drop down button and choose spin effect. Okay, and set it to play with previous with the duration of 3 seconds. Close the selection pane and open the animation pane, and you will see all the animations right here. Set it to play with previous with the duration of 3 seconds. That's fine. Now the next thing is to shorten, I think that's a duplicate entry here. So the next thing is to shorten the length of the rest of the animations, and that will be 0.25 less than the previous animation. So for the second one I will use 2.75, for the third one 2.5, for the fourth one 2.25, for the fifth one 2, for the sixth one 1.75, for the seventh one 1.5, for the eighth one 1.25, for the ninth one 1, for the 10th 0.75, for the 11th 0.50, and for the last one 0.25. okay, and finally open the selection pane again, and now we need to hide these oval here, and for that select the oval from the within from the group using the selection pane, and from the format tab click shape outline drop down button and choose no outline. Now select the next oval from the selection pane and tap the F4 key and use the same method to hide all of these ovals. Okay, now let's see the preview, and here we have our final animation. What you can do, you can select all of these animation by selecting the top one and then hold down the shift key and then select the last one and open the effect options window, and you can rotate the and you can repeat this animation 2 or 3 times. Hit the OK button. Okay, I think that's fine. Or you can also change, or you can also use different duration timings, or you can apply different rotational option just like that, selecting one animation after a gap and apply a different rotation just like counterclockwise. So let's see the slideshow. So I hope you will find this video informative and interesting. Let me know by leaving your valuable comments in the section below. And if you have learned something new and interesting through this video, then don't forget to hit the like button and share this video with your friends. You can also subscribe to our channel for more upcoming tutorial videos. Thanks for watching and have a great day.